Hello.
If I can start, I wanted to ask you, just Mina Al-Arabian with the Sharq Al-Awsat newspaper, you just finished the session about access to capital, which is a key issue for a lot of entrepreneurs. So I wanted to ask you, in your assistance programs at USAID, will you be putting more focus on entrepreneurship and actually giving assistance to entrepreneurs in the MENA region, but also in the Islam?
Well, you know, absolutely. And what we learned in the session just now is that access to capital is still a tremendous constraint for entrepreneurs, whether they are very, very small businesses, micro businesses with one or two employees, or whether they are even large scale firms trying to do industrial level projects and programs. We have a number of tools at the U.S. Agency for International Development that are addressing these challenges. The Development Credit Authority is a credit authority that allows firms to gain credit access from local banks and from international financial institutions. We have a number of venture funds that we participate in and support so that people can get access to equity financing. And we continue to provide what's called technical support or business development support to firms of all sizes around the world. So it's a very broad portfolio of programs. What we're doing in this process that the president has kicked off is to really listen to our clients and customers and partners around the world and change the way we work so that we're working in more partnership. We are focusing some of our programs on Muslim majority countries and working to support so many of the entrepreneurs that are in the room and at this conference today and really leverage their ideas and their ability to reach their own partners and colleagues in their own home countries and societies. So it was wonderful to be able to be part of this conversation.
Question is, how are the delegations are selected from the countries? Because I see that, for example, Saudi Arabia, there's only one delegation from Saudi Arabia. I didn't understand why there is only one person.
Sir, what's your name and publication?
It's İlhan Taner, Hürriyet Daily News, Turkish Press.
Well, I know that there are only about 300 people here or something along those lines, which is, of course, a very small percentage of the world's entrepreneurs that we want to listen to and learn from and dialogue with. We had the opportunity a few weeks ago to have what we call a global jam or global learning session online, where we had more than 7,000 people from more than 150 countries comment on our programs, give us ideas. A lot of the feedback was about how we could support entrepreneurs and support entrepreneurship in both the business sector, but also in the social sector. You know, a firm that is out there providing soap and hygiene education in a low-income slum community where kids have a high rate of diarrheal illness can do a lot in terms of achieving social outcomes. And those are the kinds of social entrepreneurs we try to support as well. So this conference wasn't an effort to try to bring everyone we support. We couldn't possibly have done that. But it was an effort to try to begin and continue a dialogue that really, I think, started with the president's Cairo speech and live up to that commitment that the president has to really have entrepreneurship be something that more closely ties together the American people with the people of so many Muslim-majority countries around the world.
Yes, Samir Nader with Red Bissawa. Are you considering any initiative to help governments put legislation to protect intellectual properties?
Well, we have both at the U.S. Agency for International Development and our partners, the U.S. Trade Representative and Commerce Department, all work on programs and efforts that help countries develop intellectual property protection. And in so many ways, I'm glad you asked that, because that's so important to allow entrepreneurs to have exit strategies. That's one of the things that came up in the conversation, that one of the reasons it's hard for entrepreneurs to access capital is they don't always have a clear growth strategy and then a clear exit strategy, and efforts to protect their intellectual capital, efforts to expand their access to markets are a critical part of the solution. So yes, we're working on that effort with our colleagues, and it's really in direct response to some of the things we heard today.
Thank you, Dr. Raj, for doing this. This is Hisham Bura from Ahura TV. My question is, apart from the conversation, what should we expect as deliverables from this summit? And are we going to hear like some contracts or new partnerships announced during this summit between American companies and some Muslim or Muslim country entrepreneurs?
Well, you know, I think the main point of this summit is to take forward the conversation that started with the Cairo speech, which really did launch a new beginnings and a new opportunity for partnering and supporting entrepreneurs around the world, and in particular in Muslim majority countries. We have a number of programs, and there will be a number of announced efforts that will help expand access to capital, that will help expand access to technical support, will expand mentoring between local business leaders and local entrepreneurs in so many countries. That's been an effective strategy that was commented on in the session just now. So there will be a number of those types of deliverables. There will also be a range of efforts partnering with U.S. companies to help make information about entrepreneurship more transparent, and I think between the President and the Secretary of State and some of the other upcoming speakers, you'll hear more about that.
My question is, how can we expect, I'm sorry again?
Name and publication.
National Media Agency here in the States, and how can we expect a right environment for entrepreneurship without calling for political reform in these communities?
Well, you know, in so many countries, you're right to point out that creating a business environment that is friendly, that is supportive of entrepreneurs, that allows a company to launch itself, you know, in a certain number of days. There's the World Bank's Doing Business report is something we look at quite carefully, and if it takes 400 days to get all of the registrations and licenses to start a company, that's generally not considered very friendly. In terms of the business environment. So there are a broad range of policy reforms that we believe are important and that we work on with partner governments around the world. It is true that the most powerful voices to really motivate their own governments to make those reforms are the successful entrepreneurs that you see in that room today. You know, they're the heroes of their countries. They're the ones that have built big businesses out of very little. And they have tremendous insight as to what it can take to help make that process smoother for the next generation of entrepreneurs. So we do a lot of listening, a lot of learning, and then partnering in that space.
Yeah, but on the agenda, there is anything about the political reform, which I think is vital for having a good environment for entrepreneurship. How come the agenda ignore everything regarding that?
Well, I wouldn't characterize it that way at all. In fact, when we were talking about access to capital, a number of the points made were about creating a business environment that is conducive to entrepreneurship, business startup, financing and capital access for those businesses. There'll be a number of other topics. I know the social entrepreneurship topic is one that's important, and government plays a tremendous role in supporting the social sector in that way. So I don't know exactly what the full agenda looks like, but I know in each of these sessions, the idea of policy reform, living up to a set of commitments that are required to build a stronger base of entrepreneurship, is an important part of the dialogue we're having with countries.
Are there any other questions?
Okay.
If there are no other questions, this event is concluded.